Welcome to the Daily Debrief. I'm CNET.com's Kara Suboy here with Kent German, senior editor for CNET Reviews, who specializes in cell phone coverage.
Hey, Kara.
And we are talking about some of the iPhone 3G issues that we have heard a lot of users complain about. Why don't you summarize what people are moaning and groaning about?
Well, ever since the iPhone came out, it seems like a lot of users that bought it are complaining about really poor 3G reception. And it's not only happening here in the U.S. with AT&T. We're hearing about reports from overseas, from Asia, from Australia, from Europe as well. So it really seems like a global thing going on.
And when you say poor reception, is it just the phone dropping calls or just not great coverage in smaller cities?
It seems to vary. I've heard about dropping calls, but that's not, like, dropping calls isn't necessarily a 3G thing.
Okay.
3G. Then with the 3G side, we've heard more about the 3G connection because, you know, you can see the little icon on your phone that it blinks in and out. Even in urban areas, you know, they walk into a building, maybe it blinks out, they come out, it blinks back on again. So the 3G connection isn't reliable, and then on the other hand, the call quality is also, the bars are slipping up and down, and then it's dropping calls too. So we're seeing it sort of all over.
And what does AT&T have to say for themselves? What are they saying is causing this problem?
Well, right now, they're not saying a lot. They have put out a couple reports. Their media relations people have said, well, we don't notice any real connection problems, and we're not reporting any significant network problems that they see that on their end. But, you know, users, of course, it's their experience. So if they're experiencing problems, something's definitely going on.
So what kind of recourse does an iPhone user have right now? Tough luck?
Well, one thing we have to remember is that the 3G's been around a long time, but this is the first time where a device came out, really, such a mass market device, such a wide appeal, and people jumped on the 3G network right away. Mm-hmm. Other phones that have 3G, they maybe use 3G for email, for streaming video and things like that, but you got to remember the iPhone is so data intensive with that web browser that people are really jumping out in a mass number. So it's kind of going to create some network problems, especially since AT&T rolled out a lot of their 3G network, you know, just in the past few years and really did a huge build-up in the last year. So this is a mass market thing going. But I think people can do a few things. They can go in their settings. It's in the settings on the iPhone. They can take the 3G connection. They can turn it off and on.
Okay.
Well, the iPhone is supposed to connect to the 3G network automatically when it's available, and then disconnect from it and go back to Edge when it's not.
Mm-hmm.
That doesn't always happen automatically. The phone can struggle with that connection. It can jump on the 3G connection if it has for a second, drop back. And then so sometimes that connection needs to be done manually.
Okay.
You can reset the phone network. You can go in and you can say, well, I want to connect with AT&T's network again, do it manually. Or you can go in and turn off the 3G function or turn it back on. So there's a few things you can do.
Okay. But as far as exchanging your phone in an Apple store for a new one to solve the problem, that's not going to happen.
Well, sure, you could. I think if you're having real significant problems,
mm-hmm.
but I think that if you are having a few drop calls and you talk to other iPhone owners and they're having drop calls, it's probably not related to your individual device. It's really device as a whole. Because every phone will be different in how it connects with the network, the strength of its antenna, the strength of its receiver. And the iPhone just may work differently than other phones in that sense.
Yeah, and perhaps we just have a volume issue too. There's just simply too many people trying to get onto the network.
Sure.
Yeah. Okay, well, let's hope that these problems get ironed out soon.
Hopefully, yeah. And so many people wanted this, and it's, you know, really, it is a phone after all, and that is what it does first and foremost.
Yeah, but still, a bit of a disappointment after all the hype that you mentioned. Thank you very much, Kent German. I'm Kara Suboy, CNET.com. We'll see you on the next Daily Debrief.